Ladies and gentlemen, our third contest of the evening is scheduled for 6 rounds in the lightweight division. Introducing first, boxing out of the blue corner to my left. He is sporting white trunks. He comes to us all the way from Anchorage, Alaska, making his Boston Boxing Promotions debut. Ladies and gentlemen, a warm welcome for William Parra Smith. And his opponent, standing directly across the ring, fighting out of the red corner to my right. He's wearing white trunks with blue trim. His record impressive, 7 wins, 2 defeats, 1 draw, 5 big wins by way of knockout. He was the 2020 Boston Boxing Promotions Knockout of the Year winner, all the way from Oxnard, California, the Dog, Danny Robles. 6 rounds, lightweights.
All right, here we go. 6 rounds if it gets that far in the lightweight division.
I'm sure Danny's looking to make a statement coming off of a close, very competitive decision loss to Nick Molina in New Hampshire. I'm sure he's looking.
Was that his last fight?
I believe that was, yeah. I believe that was.
That was his last. Adrian Corona was the fight before that. That was on a national broadcast out in Montebello.
That was out in California, yep.
So Robles trying to snap the string of back-to-back losses. He goes to work against William Parra Smith.
I was noticing, guys, though, before the fight, Smith, of all the guys here so far, he looks happy to be here. I was just judging by his body language. He looks eager to fight and looks happy to be here. Looks like he's an aggressive fighter, though.
Yep.
And unfortunately for him, that might play right into Danny's hands.
Yep.
Danny, when he loops his shots around the side, they're just so heavy.
Right.
I noticed in his fight with Nicky Molina, he made a little adjustments and he was punching straighter. Because Nicky's not easy to hit clean.
Right.
But when Robles opens up and gets those leverage on those wide looping shots, they're just so heavy-handed.
Especially if he catches you while you're being over-aggressive like it looks like.
Exactly.
William might be willing to be.
And he's very strong. He's very big and physically strong for a lightweight.
Robles 5'9", 175 centimeters. His reach is longer than that. 70 inches, 178 centimeters on the long reach. He weighs in tonight at 138.5 pounds.
Oh, good. See, body work.
You could just hear him. It sounds like gunshots.
Yep.
when Danny lets his hands go. Now he switches.
I was
going to
say, he's switching,
Nicky.
Yeah. I was going to say, those last couple fights I've seen.
Oh, he just got hurt.
Robles has the jelly legs going. He pops back up.
He got
looks to be okay.
Yeah.
Got caught in an exchange, no?
Got caught with 2 good shots in that exchange, but he's all there.
Waits for the 9 count, and we're back underway. William Parra Smith with the surprise knockdown.
And is this a 4-round fight, guys?
Scheduled 6-rounder.
Good counter shot there.
What Danny wants to do right now, though, is he wants to be careful. His legs are still a little shaky.
Yep.
Got hit with another clean right hand. The guy's punching short when he's punching wide. If I was Danny, I'd get behind that jab and get out of this round. He loses his balance again.
Yeah. Those left hooks are coming from left field that William's throwing. And a few of them have landed. A good counter there by Danny.
There's those heavy hands by Danny, but he's got to be careful. Oh, he just hurt his opponent. Smith may be a little hurt. What an exciting round,
right,
guys.
What a round.
Back and forth they go. Robles with a little bit of momentum now. Another big body shot right to the stomach.
We can see what Smith is going to look to do. He's going to look to go short and get in between the punches when Robles goes
when
wide.
Danny's throwing,
and that's when Danny is most powerful, is when he punches wide.
Yeah.
But Danny is now back in control. He's not winning the round, but he's back in control.
Yeah.
What a fun round, guys.
Wow,
that
round.
Was fun.
Yeah, yep. I mean, I think Danny won most of the round, but not enough to not make it a 10-8 with that knockdown.
Yeah,
you know?
When you get knocked down like that, that in and
you have to dominate the rest of the round to earn that point.
Yeah, he'd have
back.
To literally dominate him.
Yeah. But Danny looks recovered now. Like you said, I don't think his feet were totally under him at the beginning.
No, and I think he's ready to pick up right where where he planned on.
Especially seeing, I think it's a big confidence booster for Danny after hitting the deck is getting back up and then hurting him, hurting your opponent, you know.
Yeah, Kyle and guys, I think that when you see a knockdown like that, that pretty much solidifies a 10-8 round.
Right.
If it gets to the judges' scorecards at that point, usually when you see a little bit of the jelly legs,
you still got five more rounds before any of those cards matter.
If I was a betting man, I'd bet that this fight, either way, is not going five more rounds. It's not going to go six rounds.
Might not need the judges. I think if they keep that pace up.
I think some of those heavy body shots might have started to add up a little too.
And like you said, it sounds like gunshots going off when Danny's ripping those hooks to the body.
Careful right now, though, because after a minute, Smith is fresh again.
Mm-hmm.
And he knows that he doesn't want to walk into something he doesn't see.
Right,
you know
he's got enough power to feel it.
That much he should have learned from that first round.
Mm-hmm.
Catches him with a short jab and then a big right, right back to the body.
Yeah, those heavy body shots.
Seven wins, two losses, one draw for Robles.
Ooh, nice right hand by Robles. Now Robles putting that jab out there. That's a good idea just to give Smith something to look at.
I think he stayed pretty much in the orthodox position since the knockdown. He had switched southpaw, and then you called it out, and then it was soon after that. So I don't know if he was still in the lefty position, but I've noticed he's pretty much stayed orthodox, I think, since. Yep.
Hasn't been hit with anything big this round.
No, he hasn't. Oh, there you go. Switch back to southpaw. Lead.
Yeah, and being smart behind right that jab.
Ooh, good body work.
Nice jab.
Robles with a good step back there to get away from the oncoming jab. Robles working the outside of the ring this round.
I think, guys, regardless of what stance Robles is in, as long as he sets his work up with his jab, I think he'll be safe. It's when he attempts to throw these big power shots with no jab that I think he could is the only way he could get himself in any sort of trouble. But see there, he kind of, he got rocked again. Smith has a hell of a left hook because Robles, this is the second time he got hit.
And he's felt it,
yeah. Oh, nice right hand.
Oh, now Robles connecting.
It's a fun fight, man. These guys are throwing leather.
I made the comment earlier, guys, based off of his style, that I don't think Robles can be in a boring fight, but I'd say
agreed.
The same might be able to be said about Smith.
Yeah, he's been throwing
since
the opening bell.
A style that he's going to be fun no matter who he's fighting.
Yep.
Nice right hand by Robles right there. And a short left hand up to body. That body shot might have hurt his opponent a little bit there. Let's see.
Yeah.
He's bent over. Body language looks like
only
he felt
a few
one of those
seconds
body
left
shots.
In the round.
And I think even though we clipped Robles this round, I think
Danny
this is
won
a Robles
that one,
round.
Yeah. But competitive, you know, by no means dominant fashion.
That being said, Robles might still be a point behind.
Absolutely.
The first one was 10-8, and that one's 10-9.
Yeah, four rounders and six rounders, you hit the canvas, just rule of thumb, it's a good idea to win every other round. You don't need to, even in a four rounder, but it's a good idea.
Right.
And I would say, even though I think Robles won the last round, it'd be a good idea for him to win every round from here on out as well.
I don't leave anything to chance.
Yeah,
you go down in a four or a six rounder, you don't have much wiggle
much
room after
error,
that.
No. Right. He loses another rounder, gets knocked down here. Mm-hmm. It's a whole different ballgame.
Right.
I think he's back in control, but it's going to be exciting. I think he just needs to stay behind that jab and pick those body shots wisely.
Right.
right out with the jab.
Well, good body work.
Yeah, Robles, for a lightweight, his punches just sound different when they land.
Let's talk about the performance tonight from William Parrish-Smith. He traveled 4,634 miles to get to Melrose Memorial Hall tonight.
And he's fighting like he traveled that far.
You would think after that plane ride, you wouldn't be in any shape to take on one of the country's best lightweights.
He's more than willing and able.
I like everything I see from Smith. Nice sharp jab, goes up and down. He's got a beautiful left hook. He can box, he can bring it.
Yep. And he's worn some big punches from Danny well, too. I mean, those body shots are going to slow down anybody, but I haven't seen him get hit with anything up top yet that stunned him. Danny's pumping that jab.
Another hook from Smith connecting.
Yeah, and Danny's got to work a little more than he's working right now.
Good right.
And even though I think, Kyle, that his looping shots carry more power, I think he'd be safer served tonight to stick with the straight punches.
Right. Well, like you said, those in the middle of those looping ones are when he's getting caught with some of those little short shots from Smith that have had some power on him, especially that lead left hook.
That was low.
A little low, yeah.
Smith doesn't look like he's interested in taking much time.
No, I don't think so. This guy's came to fight.
Good body shot by Smith.
Yep.
Smith briefly turns southpaw back on to conventional, but a right-hand counter on the wide shot. But it's not, guys, it seems like it's Robles' heavy hands are starting to pay dividends. They're starting to slow Smith down more so than before.
He's living on the ropes more than we've seen him in the earlier rounds.
And he's punching back less.
Yeah. Danny's cutting the ring off.
Smith is nice now body spending more and more time in the southpaw stance, and I don't know why that is, Kyle. Maybe to get away from the body shots. Or
Robles is definitely sensing that Smith is starting to feel those effects.
I like what Robles did there, though. Rather than wind up, he just placed his shots in the right place. Because when you get that much, when your hands are as heavy as Danny Robles' is, he doesn't have to always wind up. He's just a heavy-handed
just
guy, period.
Yep.
Absolutely.
Oh. He's thrown that big overhand right a few times and just missed it. Switch to southpaw.
Right there is actually the range Robles has been the safest. This is when he's all the way in on his shoulders and chest, almost mugging him, because I think he's physically the stronger man.
Because Smith, though, I mean, he turns him, he shoe shines to end the round. Yep. I mean, he's doing some good things in there.
He's also going to be careful because Robles can generate an awful lot of power without much distance to do so.
Yeah, you're always one punch away with Danny turning a fight on its head, you know, with that power that he carries at that weight.
Head to the fourth round between William Parrish-Smith and Danny the Dog Robles. Parrish-Smith looking for his first victory since August the 24th of 2019 that was before a lot of things happened in this world.
Before the pandemic. Looking for his first post-pandemic win.
There was a split decision draw somewhere in the middle of there, November of 2019. His last fight was May the 14th against Alex Rivera in Dedham down in my neck of the woods on the south shore of Massachusetts. Yeah, right. Massachusetts pretty well represented at this table, guys. We got the North Shore in Chelmsford, Mr. Sean Farley. We got Fall River down on the South Coast. Kyle Cusick.
Yeah, we got the corner market, the market cornered. Nice jab by Smith. What's up, champ? Call that a
what
slip.
Happened there?
A
slip.
Yep,
I didn't
Rome
see
was
it.
Just lost his footing on that middle icon.
Another sharp left hook by Smith.
Yeah.
Good body shot by Robles. See, Robles is able to kind of mug him when he does this because he's stronger. He's physically stronger. Even though he's the taller man, he's the stronger man. And when he does this, he's kind of able to mug him. This is maybe where he wants to be.
Just keep working that body.
Smith able to get out with an uppercut.
Though, yeah, takes right back.
And he
the
hustles.
Of the ring.
That was four punches.
Yep.
Another big shot from Smith to...
I think Smith might be winning this round.
He's been a little bit busier and probably outlanded Danny a bit.
Danny's legs starting to look a little bit heavy.
Danny's the one consistently coming forward, but Smith's actually doing some good work backing up.
Yeah, and he's landed several nice left hooks to the body that seem to have Robles' attention.
Robles gets one to the chin from Smith. A couple to the right side ribs. Smith seemingly getting a burst of energy here in round four.
Yeah, and Robles' energy seems to have dipped.
Seconds to go in the fourth round. And we'll see round five.
It's weird, right? Because Danny's walking him down, but it's almost like Smith is fighting more aggressively on the two, despite being the guy backing up.
Yeah.
You know, he's busier.
Yeah, that round he was busier, regardless of who was going forward. He was the busier man. And that'll be an interesting round. To see which way the judges went.
Right.
And it'd be also a very good idea for Robles to sweep these last two rounds.
Yeah. Well, the closer we get now, I feel like both of our predictions with, I think we might actually see the cards by
we
this
might
point.
See, yeah.
And be very interesting to see how the first round 10-8 plays into, you know, these have been close rounds. You don't know what these judges are seeing or not seeing from their perspectives from the different angles.
So we will head to the fifth. Robles' last fight went a full six round. That was an absolute bloodbath with Lowell's Nick Molina. Round five underway. And Robles slips again.
Another
it's that
slip,
the middle
piece in the ring.
Yeah.
The Massachusetts State Police boxing team logo. Is on a
wipe that middle of that ring.
That's the second time Danny lost his balance because of that.
Yep.
Something the fighters moving forward should just be aware of.
Both guys getting the crowd going.
Yeah, and for two guys that aren't from Massachusetts,
right,
they got this crowd behind it.
Yep.
And what's not to be behind? It's been a fun fight.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
I'd like to see Robles get back to that jab. Instead it was Smith using it.
Another tie-up. Ref Leo Gerstel breaking it up.
Smith coming forward now, trying to put some punches together. Ooh.
And as far as their body language or their energy, right now Smith looks to be the fresher fighter. Mm-hmm. That could change any second with one shot. But
he's
right
got some
now,
bounce in his step.
And Robles doesn't seem sure, guys, what he wants to do, whether he wants to stand his ground and fight or box.
He's back to the middle of the ring. Smith backpedaling, bouncing off the ropes.
See, but when Robles uses a jab like that, Smith it's right landed. Now has no answers, yep. Right. There's that sharp hook we were yep. talking about, guys. Sneak right hand over the top. I think it's safe to say, guys, at this point that Robles is the heavier puncher, even though he's the one that tested, got hit the canvas. But I think Smith is actually faster.
Yeah, Smith's volume's been impressive. I mean, when he lets him go, he's throwing four or five punch combinations. You know, he's committing to.
Another big shot from Smith.
This is a Smith round, guys. If Robles doesn't do something to turn around, this is a Smith round.
Another one from Smith. Robles in trouble. He's getting the hooks left and right.
Another one.
There's one to the body.
Heavy shots to the body by Robles. Yep. This is where he seems to have the most success, but right. he's not staying there. And again, looking at them, you'd think, why would he want to be there? Well, sometimes body types are deceiving. Robles right. is the stronger man, and by crowding him here, he has success.
And he's also not risking getting caught with that big left hook in between exchanges from distance, right?
Exactly right, Kyle. Doesn't give the distance to get hit by the shots that he's got to worry about. Now Robles is doing a lot of work, maybe turning this round around. Yeah. This is going to be a close round, guys.
Well, I think he heard you. He just, you know, went from corner to corner, glued to his chest. And
I wouldn't want to be a judge on that round.
I know. This is tough. Yeah, it's been super close.
I mean, with the exception of
I'd have no way which
round.
Way this fight's going if it wasn't for the first round knockdown.
Again,
you know?
I would not want to be a judge on some of these rounds like that last one.
Well, other than the first round, the clear 10-8, they've all been toss-ups. They could be different on all three scorecards.
I think Robles took the second, but you're absolutely right. From the first round on, they've been toss-ups.
Mm-hmm. Always makes for a good night and a good fight on Combat Sports Now.
Definitely.
Boston Boxing Promotions will be back at home at the Castleton Conference and Banquet Center in Windham, New Hampshire on Thanksgiving Eve, the traditional Wednesday night boxing bash.
Always one of the funnest nights of the year for New England boxing fans.
Definitely.
Round six guys. Underway.
Somebody's career is about to take a good step forward, and somebody's career is going to take a little bit of a step back.
Yep.
Now Robles coming out punching with authority right now, as well, you should.
And you figure, I mean, right. The last thing Danny wants to do is continue into a three-fight streak skid, right? You know, coming off back-to-back close losses. He's going to want to try to put a stamp on this and not leave any doubt.
Absolutely.
Robles has gone the distance four times in his 10 bouts. He has logged 24 rounds in the ring. Adding a multiple to that, he will be at a square 30 after tonight.
Smith's punch is still sharp.
Mm, nice little sneaky uppercut there. Smith still calling him on, looking to lure him into exchanges. And those are the scary ones right there, right?
Yeah.
When both guys are landing at the same, you know.
Yeah, when they both kind
open
of bet
it up.
On themselves.
Yeah.
I'd say more scary, though, based off of what happened for Robles, because mm-hmm. he's the one that seems to get the worst for wear when
yep.
they exchange like that. His chin's higher in the air. He stands taller.
William Parris Smith is leaking out of his nose.
You see that right there, guys. That's kind of been the story of this fight, is Smith lands the sharper shot, and then Robles comes back with the volume.
Mm-hmm.
It's very hard to differentiate. Good left hook
good
by
check
Robles.
Hook there, yeah, definitely.
Good jab to the body by Smith.
Danny back to southpaw.
Left hook's moving. Smith lands right. Left hook and it moves Robles, though.
Let's see if the sight of Smith's blood sparks something in Robles for him to finish
sharp
off this fight.
By Robles. I mean, by Smith.
Yeah, he's landed that right hand uppercut a few times.
Oh, good left hook by both guys.
Yeah.
But Robles seemed to have the bigger effect.
But Smith is, you know, it looks like he stumbled for a second, but then he
was right back.
Yeah. He's got a chin, man.
Might have stood him up more than anything, but
right.
I agree with you.
Not many guys have worn, you know, those clean punches from Danny that well.
See, right there, Kyle, Robles landed a very heavy body shot. Nice combination.
Yeah.
But then Smith hustled and threw three punches.
Yeah.
Good uppercut. There's that uppercut we were talking about.
Danny's scoring a lot to the body here, though. Digging. Oh.
Oh, massive connection by Smith.
What a way to end the
buzzer.
Fight, right?
Very good fight.
We go to the scorecards, guys.
Wow.
There was only one round that we know the result of.
Yeah, flip a coin.
Yeah, I would not. This is a fight that I can safely say I would not want to be a judge for. There was so many close rounds.
Clearly, Smith feels confident in his performance, jumping up on the ropes.
No matter what the decision is for Smith, this is a step up.
Exactly, right.
I'd actually like to see them fight again.
I
feel like after six rounds, it was very hard for me to say who the better fighter was.
Right.
Seeing how much stamina they brought into the sixth.
An eight-round fight, right?
Yeah. I was about to say, seeing how much stamina it looked like they had in the sixth round, I'd like to see it a little bit longer, maybe eight. So await the judges' scorecards. You never know when that can happen. The last time Robles went to the scorecards, he thought he was victorious against Lulz St. Nick Molina. And the judges said otherwise and gave the victory to Nick Molina. Paris Smith looking for
his fourth victory, is that right?
His fourth victory overall and a victory in his Boston Boxing Promotions debut.
I'm curious to see how this decision goes, guys.
Yeah, me too.
We go to Peter Zimbor for the official results.
Great fight.
Very good fight.
So there you go, guys, a unanimous decision, but all three judges' scorecards were indeed different.